Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe. I am SGU, and I've got Junk Gaming Videos with me today. It's DualCom time.
And we got the Jack Hammer.
Yeah, your favorite Jack. Well, I don't know if it's your particular favorite, but a lot of you like Jack Hammer. And he's here with the A's still.
And he's hitting the deep.
What season are we in now?
I don't know, 55.
Oh, 2020, I think. Or no.
Shit.
Was last year 2020?
He just hit his 200th home run.
Oh, there it was. A milestone homer for Jack Hammer.
He jacked that out of the park.
200 career homers for Jack Hammer on his way to hopefully many, many more.
He's going to take that Barry Bonds. He's going to rip him down.
Is Mark McGwire your manager? That looks a lot like him.
He's our hitting coach, probably.
Oh, well, maybe that's it. Maybe it was him there.
I don't know.
Well, there you go. Home run number 200 of Jack Hammer's career so far. He does this here at U.S. Cellular Field. I always want to call it Comiskey Park.
Well, Comiskey Park was...
The old Comiskey was awesome. I've been there.
You know, it's old. So.
It was old, but they had awesome churros.
There's nobody in the freaking stage. Stage?
The stage? Okay. What are
the
we?
The stands.
WWE live event here or what? So that's awesome. We got a dugout scene even for the 200th homer there. He's
all partying.
Chatting it up with these guys. He's like, you know, never mind. I've been asked to be traded a million times away from you guys.
Yeah. He can never get traded.
And we keep winning championships. So it's terrible, you know. But Hammer is going to ground out there in a 4-3 ball game in the fifth.
Why is Hammer? Oh,
he got a nice.
He popped that right out the right
swing
field.
Swing on that, but I guess that didn't go nearly as far as I thought it was going to go. Thought that would find the gap.
So I guess we need to have a live stream coming up here shortly.
For
WWE.
Oh, yeah. So that will be today.
And then we may have another live stream. Quick live stream.
Yeah, we're basically just trying to catch up on content for Sunday here.
Catch up.
I bet. Put a little catch up on what we got going on. I've been slacking a little bit.
He's been busy.
Junk's been doing all my work for me.
I don't do anything. I'm junk.
No, he does. He puts out all these quality videos and
I
sends
am
them over to
machine.
Me for commentary or for DualCom in this situation here. Oh, turning a double play ball there. There you go.
Are you machine? I'm machine.
You are machine. You just wish you could feel something.
I don't feel nothing. And there goes a Joe Mauer.
Wait,
that was Zach Joe Mauer playing from yesterday.
He did it twice yesterday. Yeah. So that little 3 days grace reference was because we were at Northern Invasion last Saturday.
That was pretty fun.
Yeah, but they needed to give Hailstorm a much longer set, like three times as long as they got.
I think everybody got pissed off about that.
Pretty Reckless needed a longer set. You know who didn't need a longer set?
Anthrax.
Well, they needed a longer set. They screwed theirs up by messing up
their
sound.
But they took out Volbeat for 20 minutes,
15
too.
15 minutes. Well, I think Volbeat just started. I think they just said, like here, we're going to play.
Well, they're out of time.
Stage was far enough. I don't know why they couldn't overlap a little more if they wanted to. I mean, all in all, I kind of liked how they kept it going. But oh wow, there's a nice jump for Jack Hammer, and he steals that base by a mile. Third inning at 2-2. Still nobody in the crowd here, in the stage, as you said.
Yeah, in the stage.
Yeah, they're all hiding backstage.
This is like looking at like a Twins game here.
This is like a Tampa Bay Rays game here. You know the Rays? They had a 4-game set against the Yankees, who draw everywhere they go. 44,000 people total for a 4-game set. And that's paid. That's not just who showed up. That's paid attendance.
Oh, that's, I thought the guy took his leg right there.
That's what you call not good.
Why is this freaking fracking computer not working?
Oh, you're not even paying attention to your jackhammer commentary. You just want to get your computer started up over there.
I'm pissed off.
William Guardado, is that Eddie's son?
Probably.
Brother? Cousin?
You know,
nephew?
It possibly could be.
It could be. Somebody won that game 10-2. Was it the White Sox?
Yes.
Okay.
They won. All right. We suck.
So.
It's like Hammer. He cannot hit anyone. What the hell was that?
Oh, look at that. That was like a, I'm going to try to swing bunt here.
It didn't go for a home run, though.
Well, no, it certainly didn't. This
like
is not
the, like the look at this one.
Old school,
yes!
Nintendo games. Now, was that fair? Oh, there you go. See, you perfected it there.
Yes.
The first time around, you didn't get it, but the second time was just right. It's 5-1 Oakland in the fourth inning. Yeah.
Hammer
doesn't
know.
Casual flip to Hammer, who finishes the double playoff.
He had a double playoff.
Fifth inning. Jack Hammer. I'm trying to read the board up there. What does it say? 13 homers? 15 homers? 19 homers?
Hammer?
I don't know. It's set up there or something.
It's 23 or 24.
Well, it says 19 there. You sure we gotten that far yet?
Oh. Whatever.
Oh, I guess we know what's happening later. Double right there. I don't know. The board said 19, I thought. I don't know. Two hits in that game. Hammer is not your player of the game because of Vinny.
The, oh, shoot.
Wait. No. Am I reading that right? Wow.
What?
It actually happened.
Who the hell are these people?
He's traded. Who cares? He's traded to the Orioles. He's a Baltimore Oriole.
Oh, what?
Wow. Let's go to the spotlight here.
Ops player spotlight. Jack Hammer will be our man to watch. Playing for a new ball club after a four-player trade brought him here. And I gotta ask, how's it feel to be traded?
Well, sometimes it's a blow to be traded, and other times it's a blessing. You know, either way, you know, it's a new situation, so he might as well get used to it. The good thing about being traded is that you always know your new employer actually wants you, so hopefully he can feed off that.
Well, you know, it's not rare for us to see guys get traded and then absolutely get on fire. Sometimes a change of scenery is refreshing. Now, of course, the flip side of that is a guy can really scuffle after he gets traded as well. Regardless, trades are part of the business, and you have to be okay with that. I guess we're just going to have to wait and see how he responds to this one.
Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on the show coming up next.
Jack Hammer involved in a four-way trade that sends him to Baltimore. There are people in the stands. I guess there were people in the stands.
Well, they had to
take
away. He had to eventually get away J.J. Hardy, so they needed a goddamn.
There you go.
But the funny thing is, when I'm on, I look at the team here I'm on now.
Yeah.
Chris Davis, whom I'm always fighting every year for home runs with.
Now your teammates.
Now we're teammates.
You got Adam Jones out there.
Who has as many home runs as Chris Bryant and I do right now
in this
game.
Chris Davis.
Chris Davis. Chris Bryant.
Chris Bryant's awesome, too, though.
Yeah. This team is stacked.
Wow.
It is stacked.
Well, so, I mean, obviously we talked over and over about this, how you in real life you wouldn't get asked to, get traded away from a dynasty. But it is nice to have a fresh scene here. You're in a nice ballpark, a ballpark I love to play in there. Oriole Park, Camden Yards.
But Hammer did not do too well his first at bat. I think he grounded out right away, I believe.
Well, he's 1-for-3, it says.
Well...
So he's got that. Oh!
He just got robbed.
That was a nifty play right there behind the back, stabbed by the pitcher.
Mark Pryor.
1-1 in the 10th. Can he have a walk-off in his first game? No.
Hell no.
That's, whoa. That was kind of
bottom of the 12th.
All right, bottom of the 12th. Can he have a walk-off in his first game?
Hell no.
Nope. Hell no.
But there was a walk-off in this game.
Throw it off his helmet there.
I wonder who walked it off, too.
I'm betting Chris Davis.
Yeah, I didn't show it to you, but yeah, it was.
Was it?
Yeah.
Look at that. He is shamed in his first game. He just kind of like, we traded for that guy that hits all the home runs. And
he didn't do shit for
takes
us.
Takes his team to the playoffs and wins MVP trophies.
So I went from being 15 games in first place to a second place team.
Well, look at that, though. 47-38. I mean, that's good.
I'm down by 3.5 games.
Don't you want a thrill of a pennant race? I mean, you don't want it to be decided in the first month or anything, do you?
So right now I'm in a three-way tie for wild cards.
Hammer's got three-way. All right, here he goes.
And he is out.
No, what did he hit that with? I didn't even see him swing.
His golf club.
His bazooka?
His golf club.
Broke out the iron for that one. So that's going to be hit to short.
Whoa.
He is out.
He is gone.
So he hasn't put on like a huge clinic here yet in Baltimore. They're down 4-1 in sixth. This is going to be, Chris Davis to Hammer. Pitch recovering. Not in time.
I want replay. Replay.
Yep. Call for the replay. Sixth inning. Slaps that one the other way. He's getting slap happy. Call him slap.
Yeah. So far he hasn't done too well being a Baltimore Oriole.
He's down 1-2. You got to get some hitters counts here. Oh, but the 1-2 pitch was probably the one you hit the best. Yeah, that's a fly out. Come on, Hammer. What's going on? pressure getting to him here?
Well, you know, like they said in the spotlight, they said he's in a new ball club, so he might feel a little pressure.
This is a big spot. Oh, look at that, though. Fair ball. Well, I don't know what this
He got two RBIs on that one.
Two will score on that. So what is it, a 5-3 game now?
Now, Chris Davis coming up, and he screws it up.
Oh, they got to 5-4. That's as close as they'll get.
Come on, Davis. You screwed it up.
Colby Carter.
Yes. You love when you're in a 2020 season, you're like, who the frick are these people?
Yeah, pretty much. Look at that. Boston, two games below 500. I do not approve.
Boston.
I do not approve. Let's see. Ooh, I got to say, big time upgrade in your alternate jerseys from mustard yellow to these nice orange ones.
He might actually start doing something.
Uh-oh. He overran the ball. Can he go for it?
He's going for it.
Send him. Relay.
He's going to be toast. Perfect shot.
Oh, he had to try it, though. The way he kicked that ball around out there, you had to try it.
You know, he might do
better. 9-0, Boston.
He might do better without the mustard. You know, he always sucked when they had to wear those damn uniforms.
Yep. Wow. 13-0, Boston. I would have liked to be in attendance for this one.
You will. Trust me.
Does it get worse?
No, it gets a lot better.
15-0. All right. 8th inning.
15-0.
Oh, kick save and a beauty.
Everybody's safe. It is 15-7.
Whoa, where'd that come from? 15-7 and
we batted around.
Okay.
Look at that nice base hit.
That's gonna roll the fence. Two are gonna score.
Oh hell yeah, they're coming back.
It's 15-9. Oh, that's a heck of a comeback right there.
In the 8th inning.
Mike. Goodness. Pitching optional in this game. 15-10 is your final. Zach Koza. Isn't he a pitcher?
No, he's a shortstop.
Oh, that's right.
Plays for Cincinnati, I believe.
Oh, that dude, yeah. Like it's kind of froggy in Baltimore today. Look at that. It's like pea soup.
But Hammer likes it. He hit it out center field.
He had to hit that one through the pea soup. All right, so
can Hammer hit a home run while he's a freaking Oriole or not, man?
I don't know. You said he's got like 23. I'm expecting something.
That was close. Damn, that was close.
Yeah, he's safe, though.
You know what I didn't show? I had it.
Oh, there's Chris Davis.
That one's gone.
Going yard. Oh, high off the foul pole. That's awesome. Nice shot right there. So, will I know you yourself are not a huge seafood fan other than shrimp. Will Hammer be eating crab cakes while he's in Baltimore?
He'll be smoking them, probably. I don't know what else he'd be doing, but hey. Hammer, he's going. This one be gone? Is this gone?
It's got to be gone.
It's gone.
It's gone. Oh, that dude caught it.
I told you.
That's the one you were telling me about.
Yeah, like one hand.
Holy smokes.
That is awesome.
Do we get a replay of that?
You do. I will get a replay.
Oh, my goodness.
The guy like leans over one hand's a catch. Dude, it was awesome.
Just like snags that out of midair. Did he have a glove or no?
No. It was bare hand, dude.
No way.
This is awesome.
Let's see this. He caught Hammer.
That's pretty weak home run.
201st home run and first as an Oriole. Yes. Oh! That's the catch of the year right there. Dang. Somebody out in that little plaza area is like, I got robbed.
Hammer's putting that one deep.
Really high.
And too high. Really That's high. Way too high.
Yep. He's going to be retired on that play.
He's retarded. I retired.
Say he was retarded. I said he was retired. Okay. Wow. Well, a lot happened in this episode. He got traded. He hit his 200th homer and his 201st.
That and now he's a Baltimore Oriole.
Oh, was that 202?
I skipped a few games because you remember I had two whole series of these things.
Oh, correct. Yeah. Well, there you go. Jack Hammer, change of scenery. That's going to freshen things up here. He's going to be an Oriole for now. I guess we'll see you next time,
you know,
guys.
The funny reason why they traded me probably because I have the option of probably not signing with the club. I only have a 1-year contract.
Oh, are you coming up on free agency?
Yep.
All right. Well, we'll have to see how that plays out. We'll see you next time, guys.